So now we requested specially our director to give a inaugural address specific to our participants. So already around 124 have joined into the meeting. So I request sir to give his inaugural address and advising the participants into their how they can improve their career and thereby increasing their visibility across the country and contributing to the education of the students in the country. So I now hand over the proceedings to our director, Professor N.V. Raman Rao. Thank you.
A very good morning to all the participants. I see almost 128 participants so far joined the meeting. I think some more will join. I was told that there are 1500 requested and they have shortlisted 200. So at the outset, let me congratulate all the participants for getting shortlisted. As you are aware, that All India Council for Technical Education, through its newly established AICT Training and ATAL Training and Learning Academy, which is called as ATAL Academy, started unique faculty development programs in various thrust areas of modern technology. In fact, this they are proposing to conduct 500 such programs, and the first phase, 83 programs have been sanctioned, and among that, NIT Warangal got 8. And out of these 88 courses, 90 Warangal, among the 83 courses that were sanctioned, 90 Warangal is the only one institute to offer 3D printing in the entire country. So that is the importance of this course. So 3D printing, as you know, is a great area and is an emerging area, thrust area. And the organizers have told me that we have received about 1500 registration, and they have shortlisted 200 as per the AICT guidelines from various parts of the country. I hope you will become go back after this turning and inform so that we can also conduct more of this online on our own in behalf of the institute and allow participation for other people who are unsuccessful in getting registered. So I would like to inform you that we at NIT Varanasi took the initiation, first time in India, to start a PG program with a specialization M.Tech in additive manufacturing. Collaboration with Central Manufacturing Technology Institute, Bangalore, in the year 2014 and 15. Very recently, we have set up a world-class facility in metal 3D printing, and we have actually fabricated many things. I'd like to just show if it is visible. This is a ventilator divider, and this is a mask, and there are many things you can do with, and a lot of applications have come. You can see here and there. So really 3D printing has given us an opportunity to do things which were hitherto impossible. So far we have trained about 600 participants in the area of 3D printing and rapid prototyping. And most of you are aware that additive manufacturing also we have conducted several workshops. Additive manufacturing and 3D printing is a key in the fourth industrial revolution, what we call as Industry 4.0. So as per the ABI research report, additive manufacturing system will produce $2 trillion worth of parts and end products by 2030. As rightly identified by the AICT, as 3D printing is one among the 9 thrust areas. So they have identified several thrust areas, and this particular 3D printing is one of the primary thrusts, and we are happy to inform that we are the only institute offering this course online. And just to give a brief, the history of 3D printing in manufacturing is a story of transformative value arriving in 5 waves. Just as television did not replace radio or movies, each new wave of value from 3D printing did not receive or replace the previous usage, but opened up new possibilities. So every time there is a wave, new possibilities have been opened, new applications have come in, and it is a really good revolution. The first wave, as you are aware, is of a rapid prototyping, and it has changed the expectation regarding design iteration processes with lower costs of multiple prototypes and faster time to produce. The second wave was on indirect manufacturing, which introduced the creation of master patterns or tools with 3D printing. And the third wave was custom manufactured, offered complex individualized products based on.
அது வந்து சாய்ராம் இன்ஸ்டிடியூஷன் வரும் மேடம் சாய்ராம் இன்ஜினியரிங் வராது நமக்கு சாய்ராம் இன்ஸ்டிடியூஷன்
மட்டும் பீஸ் கைண்ட்லி மியூட் ஆல் ஆஃப் யூ பிளீஸ் மியூட் அதர்வைஸ் திஸ் எக்கோ ஃபோர்த் வே காம்ப்ளெக்ஸ் மேனுஃபேக்சரிங் யூஸ் 3D பிரிண்டிங் டெக்னாலஜி அண்ட் அட்வான்ஸ் மெட்டீரியல்ஸ் டு கிரியேட் ஸ்பெஷலைஸ்ட் ஆர் கஸ்டம் ஃபைனல் பார்ட்ஸ் இன் லோ வால்யூம் அண்ட் நவ் as a fifth wave 3D printing has arrived and 3D production has started and 3D production and additive manufacturing can simultaneously reduce number of components reduce part weight simplify design reduce product development time and improve part performance and functionality so many advantages has come and 3D production has opened the doors to agile manufacturing processes reducing the lead time from conception to production and decreasing time to market so the target industries which have actually benefited most from these AM technologies are aerospace high end mobile sectors jewelry as well as the cost associated with these technologies are rapidly falling day by day and a day will come where complicated supply chains will totally disappear So for organizing this course, I would really like to congratulate Dr. Y. Ravi Kumar and Professor L. Krishnanand of Department of Mechanical Engineering, NIT Warangal, and the head department, Professor R. N. Rao, for facilitating the organization of this course. So most of you are aware that this course is being offered through online in view of the problem that we are associated with the COVID. We all agree that we are all passing through the most difficult times. And the present need is to adopt innovative measures as per the exigencies. So the regular mode of teaching and learning has come to a standstill. Hence, today we are all attending through online mode, sitting in the comforts of our homes. So these are extraordinary times and require extraordinary efforts by one and all. I hope you'll go back and mentor your other faculty and students so that your knowledge is shared. And let us not even for a second forget that we are all immensely blessed because this has given an opportunity, online education has given an opportunity for teaching to a large number of students at a given time, anywhere, anytime. So that is something which is very unique. And I'm also happy to inform you that as we go along, NIT Warangal is also had the advantage of sharing, getting some of the best. From IITs and NITs and industries to be a part of the lectures in this particular online course and the organizers have taken enough care to invite experts from IITs and NITs and also from industries and the new norm now is to have collective sharing of resources so that all institutions which are resource rich which have experts can help resource poor institutions, private engineering colleges, and where faculty are not well trained by handholding them and also seeing that they will actually help them and make our students employable. In the previous meeting in Nagala session, you might have heard the secretary was telling how this he had envisaged about 2 years back, and this is going to the new norm, whether you like it or not. Online education is going to a new norm. Of course, it is now mandatory and important that we should be prepared to take up online teaching as a teacher, and we should invest. Institutes should invest on technology rather than on buildings, and we should also make sure that we will create a continuous opportunity for our students to learn. Facilitate learning. Learning is very, very important. If you don't facilitate continuous learning, then I'm sure the students will not be benefited with their jobs and all that. So our job is to make sure students are comfortable, students learn better, So we have to think of ways and means. Of course, any new technology will have its own goods and bads, but I'm sure this technology is not going to replace teacher. In fact, teacher's role will become more of a facilitator, where he can concentrate more on questioning the abilities or developing the skill sets for the new age jobs. And that is what is expected from the teachers. We don't have to teach them everything. Everything is available now. And today, whatever we do, can we see here, even you know, this lecture, if it's not available to many people, this is being recorded and later it can be played at their own pace. So anytime, anywhere and own pace, that is another important thing. You can learn at your own pace. Students can learn at their own pace. Try to implement, try to practice, and then how you come out with new ideas. I'm also happy to inform you that NIT Warangal has been doing very well, and we have recently conducted several online courses. So this is the sixth in the series, and in future also we'll be offering several online courses. So please keep watching our website. I would like to conclude my address by saying that tomorrow the need for technical education is a blend of both offline and online education, and that should be the practice post COVID-19. And teachers and students need to be trained on online education, because you know online education offers many opportunities to have videos, to have materials, PowerPoints taken from different sources and being displayed effectively, as you can see. And make sure that we as teachers should facilitate continuous and uninterrupted learning to our students. If that is what is met, our objectives are met. So once again, I take this opportunity to congratulate the organizers, especially Dr. Y. Ravi Kumar and Professor Krishnanand, who have been actually trying to organize this. Unfortunately, this got postponed, but everything is good, you know. It's a blessing in disguise, as COVID has given us an opportunity to conduct this online, and AICT has appreciated the efforts of NIT Warangal. And most of you are aware that recently NIT Warangal was ranked 19th among all engineering institutions and second in the state of Andhra and Telangana. So that is how we are actually building up our capacity, and we want to build capacity for teachers everywhere. And we are planning to enter an MOU with several issues so that we can train teachers continuously. So with these few words, I once again thank the organizer for giving me the opportunity, and thank you all for your kind attention. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for your encouraging words for us. See, as Professor, as Dr. Subramaniam, our